Before we start customizing the look of your captions, let's discuss the differences between closed captions and open captions. Closed captions are what you typically see on sites like YouTube and television. Open captions are what you typically see on social media platforms like Instagram and LinkedIn. The user has the option to turn off the closed captions, but open captions cannot be turned off, and they're permanently rendered into your video. Closed captions can be customized, and you can change the text color, background, text alignment, and caption position on screen. Open captions give you more customization options, like text size, background opacity, and changing font. If you want more control over how your captions look and appear, you can use open captions. This will give you the option to change the font, text color, background opacity, and font size. But to keep those changes, you must burn the captions into the video, which means the user will not have the option to turn off the captions. You can see this in films where characters are speaking briefly in a language that is not the primary language used in the film. So, there are advantages and disadvantages when using open and closed captions. Depending on your needs, you can change the standards in the import settings. For this example, we're going to use closed captions in the CEA 608 standard and the CC1 stream. You can further edit and customize your captions in the Caption panel. Make sure your caption clip is selected in the project panel or timeline. You can see all the individual caption fields in the caption panel. Here you can change the in and out time to move the captions. And in the caption text area, you can edit the caption text. And you can also add or remove captions by using the plus and minus buttons on the bottom right of the caption panel. You can change the style of your captions by using the options located at the top of the caption panel. An easy way to apply the style across all caption fields is to select them all. You can do this by selecting the first caption field and scrolling all the way to the bottom and select the last caption field while holding down the shift key. Let's talk about the options available to modify the captions. The first option on the top left is the type drop-down list, which offers you some options: pop on, roll up, and paint on. And these are typically for television broadcasting. By default, sites like YouTube use pop on. Next are the text alignment options, followed by options to italicize, underline, and add a musical note to indicate music in your scene or film. Next is the background color, followed by the text color. The last one on the right is the caption placement block. You can use this to change the position of the captions on screen, and the matrix grid offers you some default positions. You can also use the X and Y coordinates to precisely position your captions. Let's quickly change this captions clip standard to open captions to see the additional customizable options. In the project panel, select your caption clip. Right click and go to modify and select captions. This will open the modify clip window. Here, I'm going to change the standard to open captions. When you go back to the caption panel, you can see that there are more options available, like font, font size, edge, line spacing, and opacity options. Open captions do not comply with the broadcasting standard like CEA 608 and CEA 708. Broadcasting networks and sites like YouTube have pre-existing broadcasting standards to make sure captions are optimally delivered across all screen resolutions and formats. Another advantage of the CEA 608 and CEA 708 broadcasting standards is that it allows you to choose the streams. This comes in handy when using captions in multiple languages. I can place my English caption on stream CC1 and place my Spanish caption on stream CC2 by right-clicking on the caption clip in the project panel and then select Modify and Captions. This will open the Modify Clip window, where I can change the stream to CC2. Now, when I play my video, I can only see the English captions, even though the Spanish caption clip layer is visible. This is because of the streams. It's only showing me the caption on CC1. You can see how this is helpful in broadcasting, especially when you're broadcasting around the world. It's worth mentioning that CC1 and CC3 are the most commonly used streams. You can change the stream in the preview panel by going to the closed caption display settings and selecting your stream. A common problem occurs when working with captions in Adobe Premiere Pro. When you make changes to the caption clip in the caption panel or the modify clip window, the changes might not be reflected in the preview panel. This is because of the cache files Premiere Pro uses. So, if you're experiencing this problem, then it's time to clear the cache. To do this, first, save and close your project. Go to the Edit menu, Preferences, and select Media Cache. This will then open the Preferences window. Under the Media Cache Files section, press Delete. This will open the Delete Media Cache Files window. Select Delete All Media Cache Files from the system and press OK. Now, open your project. The captions should reflect the changes you have made. In the next video, we'll cover how to export your captions.